Hey y'all, my name is LaJasma and I am a natural hairstylist here in the Birmingham area. And please, please stay tuned to High Life. It is very vital and important to the community.
Hey, I'm Clyde from Fresh Ups. Stay tuned to High Life.
Thank God we made it. I can't wait till I sign the deal.
Can't wait till I sign the deal, Frank.
Thank God we made it to the High Life Show. With
hey, y'all. Welcome to High Life, your number one show for urban news and entertainment. I'm your host, B-Web. I hope you're doing good, and I hope you're keeping your head up.
It's warming outside, and you know when it gets warm in the South, it's immediately time to pull out the grill. Today, I want to put on for my high school classmates from the good old E.B. Irwin on the east side of Birmingham. In a little place called Centerpoint. So many greats walk those hallways. Shout out to all the entrepreneurs making a way out of none. In honor of Women's History Month, I have a special guest with an amazing story.
My name is LaJasma Johnson. I am from here, from Birmingham, Alabama. And what I do, I own my own business. The Naughty Crown is a natural hair salon. I have been doing hair for over 25 years. I have been licensed for 15 years, and I recently got my natural hair license 2 years ago. I've always known I wanted to take it serious as my business. It's just that when I initially started out, they didn't really have a niche for natural hair. There wasn't a whole lot of places I could go to learn about it. So I kind of stepped away from the hair industry. And then once it became a movement, I kind of saw this as my opportunity to step full throttle into what I've always been passionate about. Honestly, I love hair. And the thing that really pushes me is just being able to teach black women and black girls the beauty of their natural hair in its natural state. I have been doing hair since I was a child. I basically was self-taught, and it just kind of went from there. I've looked in every avenue possible to better my talents when it comes to hair. I've gone to Detroit for Sister Locks. I went to Texas and studied under Isis Brentley to learn about natural hair. I went to Braided Lock Bliss in Florida to learn about locks and the different styles. And I've just grown my passions from there. I specialize in natural hair as a whole. I like locks. I like Sister Locks, but I really like natural hair. Being able to showcase the different style options available for natural hair as opposed to just the simple silk press. I just want to be able to show the artistic way that we can style our hair in its natural state. Helping women be able to see themselves as beautiful, naturally beautiful, not having to force themselves into a Europeanized standard of beauty because that's not who we are naturally. So just allowing them to just be able to look at themselves and love themselves the way God created them and their Afrocentric features. In the future, I am currently working on opening up a mobile hair salon. It's going to be a luxury mobile hair salon that caters to women of color with beautiful natural crowns and textures of different curl types and patterns. Start with yourself. When I say that, I mean start with loving your own hair, learning your own hair. You can't really be the best at doing other people's hair until you're really comfortable with your own hair and knowing how to learn your hair. Then that allows you the avenues to better assist other people. Never stop learning. There's always going to be new techniques, new styles. Always search them out and stay on whatever is trending, and not just doing it for the purpose of aesthetics, but actually learning how to take care of people's hair in a healthy manner. So the advice I would give would be never stop learning. Never stop learning. Always find ways to educate yourself and your craft. It's important to be proud of your black hair because for so long we've not been allowed to. we've always been told that we have to conform or hide our hair, or it's not acceptable the way that it is, it's unruly, and those things affect your self-esteem and how you look at yourself and other Black women. Find me on social media. I have a Facebook page, an Instagram page, and a TikTok. All of them are The Naughty Crown. It's T-H-A. Crown is spelled with a K. And I also have my own website, which is linked in the bio on all of my social media platforms. Hey, y'all. My name is LaJasma, and I am a natural hairstylist here in the Birmingham area. And please, please stay tuned to High Life. It is very vital and important to the community.
It's your boy Ken XL chiming in. Make sure y'all tap in with Highlight TV and be real.
Man, I'm pressed to the 7, man. And y'all in my city, Birmingham.
Highlight TV, y'all too. Fuck you.
Hey, I'm Tavia. Stay tuned to High Life.
My name is Kashif Yamin. I'm with Yo Chef Surf and Turf Smokehouse. Stay tuned to High Life.
Good people, great drinks, amazing vibes. The Vibe Bar and Lounge is dedicated to give you a smooth, eventful night out. Try out our hookahs, rainbow shots, and our signature drinks. Located at 3801 Richard Arrington Jr. Boulevard, Birmingham, Alabama. It's always a vibe at the Vibe Bar and Lounge.
It's not easy to be an entrepreneur, but if it's your mission to serve the people and be your own boss, why not? Remember, you have the power to create the life you want. Our next interview is Clyde Walters. Congratulations on opening up your barbershop. Wishing you nothing but abundance.
My name is Clyde Walters. I'm a barber in Birmingham, Alabama. My barbershop is Fresh Ups, exit 128, Tallapoosa. I've always been in a barbershop. I always grew up in a barbershop. I remember being young, being the only child in the barbershop amongst men at 2 o'clock in the morning, you know what I'm saying? I remember a lot. You know, everybody knows, the fellas know what's going on at the barbershop. There's a lot of things that we don't talk about, you know what I'm saying? Like, I've always been at the barbershop, even with my boys. We never miss a Saturday, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was just mandatory that barbershop. I guess I'll say at the point where you're trying to figure out what you really want to do for the rest of your life, like, everybody gonna have that. I guess they call it a midlife crisis. That what it is? I don't know. Some people say that, but you just job after job, not really want to work for nobody. I'm good at giving directions and not taking them, which I figured out, you know what I'm saying? So a lot of things led me that way. And I had a couple of things on the list that I wanted to do, and this is the one that I chose, you know. I've been barbering for 4 years. Not to mention, I never cut hair. Like, shout out to T. Hardy. T. Hardy used to cut my hair back in the day. Shout out to Snow. We all went to school together. But I never picked up the clippers when I was young. I knew how to draw, and I always wanted to stay fresh. At this point, I'm at the drawing board to where, like, a long list of goals that I had set for myself, I'm like at the end, I am at the end of, and it's like I'm back at the drawing board. So, new barbershop grand opening, but I'm also opening an event center, which is my old barbershop. And also a car wash, and all these three things are going to be implemented in the same area, like in this lot. So I got a couple of things up my sleeve, but yeah, slowly but for sure, sooner than later. If you come to the grand opening, you can expect love, family, a good time, like them old barbecues y'all used to have when y'all was young. Everybody running around. Uncle got a barbecue grill, like, you know, good time, just love, you know, just love. Never know who's gonna come to that door. That's how I be looking at it, and that's how I be taking it. Cause you never know who's gonna call or come through that door, what type of situation they going through, what they got on their mind, or want to get off their chest, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I love this show, because it's a open door for a lot of a lot of things if you use it the right way.
The people is one thing I love about it, because
you have so many different type of people. Like
within a month's time or 2 months time, so many people get in my chair, from doctors, from restaurant owners, gas station owners. If I
was just to write down everybody's occupation and just put it on a long list, you know what I'm saying? And if you really think about it, that's very resourceful, you know what I'm saying? And that's for a lot of barbers, you know what I'm saying? And the black community, if you think about it, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody need a plumber, you know, everybody need an electrician, you know what I'm saying? Like, I love those things about my job. It was so important for me to break out and be an entrepreneur, because I feel as if that I'm paving the way for my kids, for them to think different. That's what's big about me, them thinking on their own and not being followers. Like, nowadays it's a little different out here, to where it's easy. If you got an idea, it's easy. If you serious about your idea, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's easy, it's no limitation. So if you have that mindset, then you can do what you want to do. To up and coming entrepreneurs and barbers that stop wasting time. What I'm doing right now, I was supposed to do 12 years ago. Somebody was telling me, and I didn't want to listen. I was young, I want to be a hustler. Stop wasting time. Like, you know, when you young and you, like, when you young, in them early 20s, like, money be, it's gonna be so quick through your hands. If you can stop and write now, I ain't say type in your phone, if you can write down something that you want to do, something that you can be doing, productive, then you'll be well off, like, very sooner than later. My favorite cuts to do is Fatback. That's my favorite haircut, the Fatback. I rocked the Fatback when I was young, but I ain't rocked it in years, but I love the Fatback. A lot of people know me up from that Fatback, but I love the Fatback. Down here in Birmingham, we call it the Belma. But I'm from the east side, but I used to rock that Fatback. It's only a few people in the city that rock that Fatback now. I ain't gonna name no names, but we know which side of town y'all on. Shout out to the Fatbacks, you know what I'm saying? There was a few on the east side that were rocking the Fatback. You know who you are, don't forget about them Fatbacks. You can find me on Facebook, Clyde Walters. Instagram, Fresh Ups with a Z. Fresh_ups with a Z. I don't know my snap and all that. I really don't be on social media for y'all, for real. I don't be on that for real, I ain't gonna lie. I try to stay away from social media so I can get things done. But when I do go home, I kind of jump on my tablet and I scroll. So if I don't be liking y'all pictures and stuff, it's because I be trying to stay away from that so I can get this done and get this done. But I do be watching. When I do be watching, I be liking and loving. I ain't liking, I be loving. I don't like, I love, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, appointments. I don't want to go to the app. I don't want to go to the app. So I require everybody to call my phone, and then ahead of time, and then I put them down in the books. But I'm slowly for surely going to slide that way toward the app, just to get everything organized, you know what I'm saying? And my grand opening comes, so I'm expecting some barbers and beauticians. And so I just want everything to be organized. So I'm going to fade to the out, but bear with me. But my contact me on my cell, 205-484-8499, and book you and then go from there. Hey, I'm Clyde from Fresh Ups. Stay tuned to High Life.
an experience for all your beauty needs. Natural hair services, butt lift and body contouring, cranial prosthetics, weight loss counseling, and so much more. Owned and operated by Marquita Jones. Located at 6821 First Avenue North, Birmingham, Alabama. Call for your consultation at 205-413-6127. The one, the exception, Exception Beauty.
You have the power to create the life you want, and you also deserve great things to happen to you. If you're interested in being a guest or for advertisement, contact us at highlifetvshow@gmail.com.
Until next time, stay safe and positive. I'm B. Will with High Life. Can't wait to meet you in the clouds.
Thank God we made it. I can't wait till I sign the deal.
Can't wait till I sign the deal, Frank.
Thank God we made it to the High Life Show with